Anatomically, we're looking at biceps, triceps, wrist extensors, and wrist flexors. And physiologically, we're looking at Fitt's model of cognitive, associative, and autonomous stages of learning.
Set up a practice schedule with your group.
First, gather all the equipment that you'll need for this experiment. We used an 18-inch standard dartboard, 6 standard darts, and any tape measure with centimeters. Place your dartboard in a location where it won't be too low. According to biomechanics, this is a projectile, so you want the takeoff angle to be 45 degrees. Measure 10 feet from you to your board, and you want it the same level as your throw.
Be sure the environment around and behind the board are clear of people. The darts are very sharp and you don't want to injure anybody. Then you can start your trials. Throwing 6 darts individually, we measured each one's distance from the bullseye and then averaged the score of all 6 for each trial. Any darts that didn't land on the board were simply rethrown so that the score could be measured.
During acquisition, the subjects are still in cognitive learning.
In the blue, prince withdrawn from a dream of mine.
Be sure to record all of your data and then make averages for each trial.
Yep.
We experienced some error in our data due to wind from the environment and from inexperienced throwers. It may be better to use an environment that has a stable background so that you don't lose the darts such as we did in this experiment. For her retention test, this subject used a different environment with many distractors around the board.
During testing, the subjects are approaching more the associative stage of learning.
The other 2 subjects, however, used the same background. As you can see, the technique here has improved through the acquisition and retention phase. This subject's technique improved as well, much smoother than it did during the acquisition phase. For transfer, we used 15 feet instead of 10 feet in order to see if learning occurred.
Novice throw. Expert throw.
Notice the large difference in technique between the novice and the expert.
Novice.
Expert throw. Notice that they throw it with the dart more directly in front of their face, keeping the dart, the board, and their eye all in one line.
Novice throw. Expert. Writing my paper.
As you can see from the data here, all of the subjects improved during their acquisition and retention trials. The large spike in this subject's test is thought to be due to change of environment for testing. Her transfer score, however, shows improvement, which means that learning occurred.
This subject's data showed that she improved during her acquisition and retention phase. Her transfer score, however, decreased, showing that she didn't learn the skill as much as retain it. The same can be said for the final subject. Her score didn't increase as much throughout the trials, but she still retained it very well. Her transfer, however, shows that she very much retained it rather than learned the skill.
None of the subjects ever reached the autonomous stage of learning, but either remained in the cognitive or more likely the associative stage.